Hey guys, Mike Henry here, and we're talking about the Rheem hybrid heat pump water heater. And in this video, we're going to talk about condensate management. Now, I'm sure you're aware that electric water heaters don't produce condensation, but you're probably aware that heat pump water heaters do. Why is that? Well, in short, the heat pump is extracting the heat from the air, and in so doing, the water vapor in the air quickly reaches its dew point and condenses. So, what do we need to do with that water? Well, there are a few important recommendations in the use and care manual that comes with the water heater, and we'll take a look at those now. First, the unit comes with a 3/4 inch female threaded NPT connection, and that means you're going to need to start off with a male adapter. When you're making that connection, you can use a thin layer of pipe dope or Teflon tape. Personally, I like to use clear silicone on those male threads, and it should never be over tightened. Hand tight is usually enough. Remember, it's just a drain. Next, a T-fitting should also be installed with a removable cap so that the drain line can be inspected and cleaned out on a regular basis. The connection point is 3/4 inch and should never be reduced in size. Now, since this is just water and not acidic condensate, it doesn't need to be treated, so you can route the drain piping to a plumbing drain, to the outside of the house, or if you're below grade, to a condensate pump. Just don't route it into the drain pan. The water coming out of the unit can be pretty cold, so the drain line itself might begin to sweat. If that's going to be a problem, you might need to insulate it as well. And lastly, how much water can we expect? There are a lot of factors involved to give a direct answer to that question, but this water heater could produce up to 2 gallons of water a day, maybe even more. But remember, since it's just water, you could just use it to water your plants. I hope this video has been helpful. Thanks for watching.